want to acknowledge today is what really makes the Respite Center building, taking care, helping, allowing people to grow and mature into the best they can possibly be, is the staff that do it day in and day out. So if I could have everybody who has worked or is working at the Respite Center, please stand up. And come forward.
Have them come forward. You don't have them come forward.
There's also one other person we'd like to acknowledge today, and that's Linda Perlstein. Where are you, Linda? Linda has volunteered for 20 years, almost 3 days a week, in the daycare center. So we, and she started with us, and she's still with us, so we owe you a special thank you, Linda. Thank you. Now, another source of great support that many of you know is the Natick Fire Department. And I'm going to ask Pat Stanhope and the Natick Fire Department to come forward, please. The Natick Fire Department and the Respite Center have just an unbelievable relationship. And it comes from Jerry Stanhope, which most of you know, which was a fellow firefighter of the Natick Fire Department who passed away. And his son Michael was one of those first four that I was talking about when we opened the Respite Center. So the Natick Fire Department is very near and dear to our hearts. They support us in so many ways. And each year they work to get us extra waivers to get into the Boston Marathon. And then we put the money raised by their runners into a Jerry and Michael Stanhope Scholarship Fund, which honors the memory of both Jerry and his son Michael. So I'm going to let Danny talk a little bit.
Well, as always, it's an honor for us to be here. Chief White, Captain Ron Downing. First, I gotta say, those pictures of you guys 20 years ago, these two are as beautiful as they are today than they were 20 years ago. The 1,000 lives that you guys have touched in that 20 years just blows me away. So, you two are just amazing.
This year they presented us with a check for $44,450. Thank you, Natick Fire, for so many years of
here and all of the people at the Respite Center. They're what makes this Respite Center what it is. And Emily came to us 7 years ago. She rolled in and she said, that's it, I'm coming here. And she wanted to make a little speech for all of you to kind of give you a feel for what she feels.
Hi, my name is Emily Bill. I have been going to the Respite Center for 7 years. The Respite Center provides so much love and support. Being a chair in the Respite Center, I want to thank you for saving my life and taking me in. I don't know what I would do without the Respite Center. It means the world to me. Thank you, brothers. I could not do it without you.
The next part of our ceremony here is all our families, you all pitched in and you all sent us checks to help support the cost that DDS can't afford, the transportation for our adults in the program, for our respite for babies, and you all, standing is going to present the check to you. She's in our day program.
Hi, my name is Sandy. I am here to present the check from all the respite families. This year, the families donate $18,150 to the medical team. Thank you, respite. You are awesome.
At this time, can I please have anyone who's running on the DELL EMC team to come on up? So there will be 16 other people running on Monday, but I was going to thank the runners. And on behalf of DELL EMC and our runners, I'm happy to say that the company has donated over $200,000 this year to the Respite Center. And as I mentioned, it's always a pleasure for us to work with the Respite Center. We're definitely looking forward to the relationship going forward. And at this time, can I also ask for anyone who is running on Team Respite to step forward as well?
This year, we will have 71 runners run the marathon for us on Monday. Second. 19 for us.
So actually, this is my 22nd Boston Marathon, and I have run all 20 of those for the Respite Center. So just very grateful because the wonderful film said it all. 20 years ago, we were at a little table with four runners and four comrades. And what a great beginning it was. We had no idea it was going to grow as it's grown, but faith in these two wonderful women who, just as the chief said or whatever, how beautiful they looked then, and I mean, they look pretty good right now, too. Their passion and their love and their dream is still resonating with each one of you that's lucky enough to be part of this wonderful family. And the word when I was riding on the plane and actually running this week, I was thinking, what word kind of summarizes to me the Respite Center and the journey and the place? And I came up with the word joy. And then I heard Sharon say it in the video, like, I think I counted 8 times, and we repeat each other all the time. So I just brought tears to my eyes, because Michael had such a complete joy. He lived joyfully for 10 years, and he shared that with our immediate family, and certainly you are carrying on that joy. And when you run on Monday, know that that joy will just take you from the start to the finish, and just how blessed we all are to honor him and support the Respite Center. Thank you.
There's one other person we would be remiss if we didn't bring it forward. Now I'm looking forward, Mario. So to many of you, this is not a stranger. To everyone who knows, this is Wendy's husband, Mario. And Mario will be running his first Boston Marathon on Monday. Accomplishment for Mario, but I also have to tell you, Mario, and with a little bit of Wendy's help, have raised $30,000 on their contest. First of all, Mario is that kind of like go-to guy that comes and helps us out whenever we're in a spot, and then we need somebody to plow the snow, we need somebody to help us fix something. It's Mario, so, but Monday, he's just one of our runners. Thanks. So, guys, we want to thank you so much for all you're doing, and hope Monday goes as well as it can possibly go for each one of you. But you also need to know that what you've done prior to Monday will keep us going for an entire year at the Respite Center. 6 months from now, we will still be going for what you've done for us. 9 or 2 months from now, we will. It just, this is Michael Mullins. So just know that what you've done will last us until next Marathon Monday next year, when we'll start again. So our sign language class has been practicing a song for you for months and months and months. So I'm going to ask you to follow Mark. Just right around your coat, so you'll go to the back, and they're going to perform for you.